Lab 5. In this lab, we're going to go ahead and take a look at the functionality inside SOLIDWORKS for creating a sheet metal oven ventilation enclosure. And as you can see here from the drawing, you can see the specs that are required. And we'll be using the sheet metal functionality to unfold it as well. Now, this isn't actually like 100% how it would really be designed in real life. It's just to give you basically an overview of how, some of the functions and tools that are built into the software. So engineering, from an engineering standpoint, it's not really what how you would necessarily make this part. But let's go ahead and start with the new part file. And we're going to go ahead and select the front plane, start sketch, the right plane, start sketch. And we're just going to draw in some of the geometry that's there. So let's first give ourselves some geometry as far as the height of this. And if we look at the print, it needs to be 8 inches high. Okay, we'll just zoom out there. And then we'll draw the profile as we see it. Okay, then from here we'll go ahead and dimension this at 33 inches and this at 18 inches. Okay, the angle between these two is going to be, let's see here, 11 degrees. And finally, there should be a dimension, there we go, 4 inches from the top edge. Here to here is going to be 4. Let me just verify that again. Actually, I think it's supposed to be 9 inches. Yes. Okay. Now, what we're going to do from this point on, we'll just go ahead and extrude that. We want to extrude it mid-plane, and then the width is going to be 36 inches. Now select this top face and start a sketch. I could go normal too. And we're going to go ahead and I'm just going to draw a cutout off this edge. And put the dimensions in according to the print. This edge here, that's going to need to be 25 degrees. And then it's positioned 19.912 off this edge here. Okay, then I could just simply go to Features, Extrude Cut. Make sure you flip the direction of the cut. That little arrow needs to flip. So it has to cut everything on this side. You could always hit flip side to cut. All right, now we're just going to mirror that over. So if we select the right plane and the cut extrude that we just added, go to mirror and hit the green check mark. All right, now we're going to go ahead and shell this out. It needs to be 100 thousandths thick. So we're going to go to the shell command. Endpoint 1 works really well. We just select the bottom face, and it's done. Now we want to rip this apart and unfold it. So if you go to the sheet metal tools, you'll find the rip tool. Now Insert Bends also has the rip tool built into it, but we're going to use the rip tool here just separately, just from the standpoint of so you can see what it does. Okay, we just need to select the edges that need to be ripped with both arrows pointing the way they are. That means it's going to completely notch out the corner. That might or might not be, may not be desirable, but we're going to leave it the way it is. You could always go back and tinker with them, but they should all try and match. If you have an arrow pointing in one direction, make sure they're all pointing the same. It doesn't necessarily flip-flop very well. And I'm just going to select that edge there, and this edge right here. So if you look from the bottom, you can see these corners down here and these edges as they go all the way up. So just be very specific. You see these blue edges here? I'm going to stop for a second so you can take a close look at it. Make sure yours looks exactly the same. Flip it over here. Take a close look at it. Make sure it's exactly the same. And then flip it around. You can see this corner, just that edge. And then this edge here. Hit the green check mark. Okay, now we could go to insert bends, and we'll just go ahead and let it at 0.029 stay at that. Select this as our fixed face. You can select K-factor, bend allowance, bend deduction, or bend calculation. K-factor of 0.32 is pretty much a sweet spot with many vendors that are out there. You might see different K-factors depending upon the vendor. Okay, also the auto relief, we'll go ahead and keep it with rectangular, but know that it's hair and not round as well, and we'll keep it at 0.5. And here's the rip parameters. Had we gone through this before ripping, we could have actually now selected those edges to rip out. But that's okay. We did it earlier just so we could keep it separate and keep it simple. The green check mark, it's just going to give you a little message. Auto relief cuts were made for one of our bends. That's fine. It needed to do that. And now if we zoom up here, you can see it's actually put in there's the relief cuts in the corners. And the bends are in there. So now if we were to go to flatten, we have our flat pattern. Okay. To get those other features in there, what you might want to do is actually we could just go ahead and select this face and start a sketch. We could draw in the geometry that we had there for the ventilation. Just put your dimensions in according to the sheet. Could actually draw a diagonal center line to get centered if we wanted to. And then do the same over here. And then match both. And actually, let's right click. Not better yet, we'll just use points. Find the midpoint of each one. And just drag it to it. There you go. Okay, go to Features, Extrude Cut, and Link to Thickness just goes through the one layer of sheet metal. Okay, could do the same over here, select this face, start a sketch. And go ahead and you can put in a series of cutouts. I'll just use the linear sketch. Go ahead and put in a few copies. Actually, I don't want to go across. On the go up and down. Just flip that. Put three in. Okay. And we could mirror that over. We just draw a center line. Make sure it snaps vertical. Select it all. Go to mirror. Wanted to mirror about this line. There we go. Okay, put your dimensions in and then just extrude cut and link to thickness. Any other features that were on the print, go ahead and do that. I'm not following the print exactly here, but let's go ahead and go back to sheet metal and we should be able to flatten it out. And you can see the features stay in the position. And that concludes this lab.